Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, welcome to this ecumenical prayer, which commemorates the 500 years of the Reformation. For over 50 years, Lutherans and Catholics have been on a journey from conflict to communion. With joy, we have come to recognize that what unites us is far greater than what divides us. On this journey, mutual understanding and trust have grown.
So it is possible for us to gather today. We come with different thoughts and feelings of thanksgiving and lament, joy and repentance, joy in the gospel and sorrow for division. We gather to commemorate in remembrance, in thanksgiving and confession, and in common witness and commitment.
Let us pray. Jesus Christ, Lord of the Church, send your Holy Spirit. Illumine our hearts and heal our memories. O Holy Spirit, help us to rejoice in the gifts that have come to the Church through the Reformation. Prepare us to repent for the dividing walls that we and our forebears have built, and equip us for common witness and service in the world.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from Conflict to Communion. Lutherans are thankful in their hearts for what Luther and the other reformers made accessible to them, the understanding of the gospel of Jesus Christ and faith in him, the insight into the mystery of the triune God who gives himself to us human beings out of grace and who can be received only in full trust in the divine promise, the freedom and certainty that the gospel creates, in the love that comes from and is awakened by faith, and in the hope in life and death that brings with it, and in the living contact with the Holy Scriptures, the catechisms, and hymns that draw faith into life, in the priesthood of all baptized believers and their calling for the common mission of the Church. Lutherans realize that what they are thanking God for is not a gift that they can claim only for themselves. They want to share this gift with all other Christians.
Catholics and Lutherans have so much of the faith in common that they can be thankful together. Encouraged by the Second Vatican Council, Catholics gladly acknowledge and esteem the truly Christian endowments from our common heritage, which are to be found among our separated brethren. It is right and salutary to recognize the riches of Christ and virtuous works in the lives of others who are bearing witness to Christ, sometimes even to the shedding of their blood. For God is always wonderful in his works and worthy of all praise. In this spirit, Catholics and Lutherans embrace each other as sisters and brothers in the Lord. Together, they rejoice in the truly Christian gifts that they have both received and rediscovered in various ways through the renewal and impulses of the Reformation. These gifts are reason for thanksgiving. The ecumenical journey enables Lutherans and Catholics to appreciate together Martin Luther's insight into and spiritual experience of the gospel of the righteousness of God, which is also God's mercy.
Let us pray. O God of mercy, we lament that even good actions of reform and renewal had often unintended negative consequences.
We bring before you the burdens of the guilt of the past, when our forebears did not follow your will, that all be one in the truth of the gospel.
We confess our own ways of thinking and acting that perpetuate the divisions of the past. As communities and as individuals, we build many walls around us, mental, spiritual, physical, political walls, walls that result in discrimination and violence. Forgive us, Lord. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you are called to peace. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share with each other a sign of reconciliation and peace, and we will sing following the sharing of the peace.
As we continue our journey from conflict to communion, let us hear the gospel according to John. Jesus said, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that bears no fruit. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes so that it may bear more fruit. You have already been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing." The Gospel of our Lord.
Thanks be to God.
First of all, thank you to all of you for being here this evening. Bishop Quinn and I were just sharing with one another. This is something for which so many of us have longed. And what a delight it is to be able to gather together. So, again, my thanks to God for the gift of being able to worship together with Bishop Quinn. And our thanks to Pastor Wall and the people here at Bethel for opening this lovely setting as a place for us to gather. So here are some of the words that we've already heard spoken this evening. For over 50 years, Lutherans and Catholics have been on a journey from conflict to communion. With joy, we have come to recognize that what unites us is far greater than what divides us. Catholics and Lutherans have so much of the faith in common that they can be thankful together. Reading and hearing those words brings such joy to my heart that I sometimes have to fight back the tears. And here's why. What began 500 years ago with the Reformation certainly brought about some great awakenings of God's presence and activity in the world and in the church and in the lives of people. But it also led to some unintended negative consequences, resulting in divisions, in discrimination, in conflict, sometimes even in violence. One of my saddest memories is, as a child, the Lutheran church in which I grew up, Reformation Sunday typically became a day to denigrate and vilify Catholics. Every time I think about that, I get sad again. And so, as a bishop in the Lutheran Church, I ask forgiveness from you, my Catholic sisters and brothers, for any pain that I or others have caused through these past 500 years. Lord, have mercy. But today I give thanks for how far Lutherans and Catholics have come, how far we've come under the presence and guidance of the Holy Spirit. Realize that for the past 50 years, which is 10% of those 500 years, for the past 50 years, we Catholics and Lutherans have been on a journey from conflict to communion. We have come to recognize that what unites us is far greater than anything that can ever divide us. This worship service is a sign of that unity in Christ that is God's gift to us. Another sign of our unity, and one of my greatest joys, is an annual gathering of the Lutheran and Catholic bishops in Minnesota. And that gathering just took place last week. And there we focused on ministries of mercy. And what was emphasized throughout that time together was that God's very essence is mercy. It's not just that God acts in merciful ways. God's very essence is mercy. And that mercy is shown most powerfully in the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. And that's what forms us into those who are Christ to one another and for one another, and especially to those who live on the margins of society, because often that's what our ministries of mercies are about. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for the Lord is good. Now that we have come this far, let there be no turning back. For many years, maybe we tolerated each other, but over the past 50 years, we have begun to learn how to embrace one another. I still remember several years ago, as I was trying to figure out why African ministry with Africans worked in some congregations and not others, and I got my answer from a woman who was an immigrant from Colombia. And she said, "I don't just want to be tolerated. I want to be embraced." As the beloved children of God, the Creator, may we continually see the image of God in one another. And as branches of that one true vine, Jesus Christ, may we witness together to the mercy of God in our proclamation and in our service. And as the church, the body of Christ, may we continually be reformed and transformed by the presence and power of the Holy Spirit. May we be
dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, what a privilege this is for me as the Catholic Bishop of the Diocese of Winona to receive your very gracious invitation to come and to be part of this worship service. Thank you for inviting me, and especially thank you, Bishop Delzer, for your warm friendship and inviting me to share the homily tonight. It's a great blessing and privilege for me. And all of our Catholics who are here tonight, we thank all of you, our sister and brother Lutherans, for your warm welcome here at Bethel Lutheran. We do feel at home. And thank you for reaching out to us as you commemorate the 500th anniversary of the Reformation. What a wonderful blessing that we're here with you tonight in praying together. I hope all of our hearts are touched by such an outpouring of grace. Whenever I hear that gospel passage about Jesus talking about the vine and the branches, I always think about how when you get a vine growing together, it gets stronger. And in fact, when a vine really grows, when you get an opportunity to have to trim it or prune it, you realize how strong that vine becomes. In fact, it's hard to go ahead and cut through it. When a vine grows, it's strong. Jesus says he's that vine, and all of us are the branches. But you know, with our lives, we're well aware we belong and that we're in community, but we're also individuals. And sometimes as individuals, it's a struggle with the community. I think of my 7-year-old great-nephew, how he used to love to show me his Lego and be able to see what he was building, how he would love to be able to take me to his room and show me what he was working on. But then also he became aware of being an individual. And one day when I was there, and his shoelace was undone, and I bent down to tie it for him, He says, "Oh no, Uncle John, I do that myself." He had learned he's an individual. And now he's grown up. He can't wait for 16th birthday to get that passport to life, known as the driver's license. And he's counting down the days because he too is aware of his individuality. Well, so is the church. We're a big community. We're a big family. But also we're individuals. And to remain in that family, like tonight, we have to realize we got more in common than anything that divides us. We have to also realize that in the history of this church, God has also raised up individuals like Martin Luther to go ahead and call the church back to a greater moment of holiness, to go ahead and invite the church to come back to gospel simplicity, to invite the church to care for others with a deep mercy and love. When we do that, and when we're individuals who remain part of that vine, boy, we really become stronger. That church that belongs to Jesus Christ, which is all of us. At times, we got to be pruned. Sometimes our selfishness, our prejudices, the times that we haven't asked for forgiveness. How important it is for that vine, for us to stay attached to it. That is, while we're individuals, we belong to the church, to the community of Jesus Christ. Well, as Bishop Delzer said, there's no going back. We've come so far, and the grace of Christ and the outpouring of the Holy Spirit has led us. I too apologize for any division, for any wounds that as Roman Catholics we may have inflicted on the body of Christ and to any of you. We apologize. Christ is the healer, but each of us in our human way needs to seek that forgiveness and to let others know we are truly sorry and Christ has opened a new avenue, a new pathway of grace where we stay in prayer. We work and love and care for one another to be his presence in the world. Well, vines are hard to pull apart. In fact, they grow together in such a way you wouldn't be able to take one part from another. So to the church and the journey we're on, we stay connected to Jesus Christ. He's the vine. And all of us, his branches. Our ecumenical journey continues. In this worship, we commit ourselves to grow in communion, the five imperatives found in From Conflict to Communion will guide us.
Our first commitment. Catholics and Lutherans should always begin from the perspective of unity and not from the point of view of division in order to strengthen what is held in common, even though the differences are more easily seen and experienced.
Our second commitment. Lutherans and Catholics must let themselves continuously be transformed by the encounter with the other and by the mutual witness of faith.
Our third commitment. Catholics and Lutherans should again commit themselves to seek visible unity, to elaborate together what this means in concrete steps, and to strive repeatedly toward this goal.
Our fourth commitment, Lutherans and Catholics should jointly rediscover the power of the gospel of Jesus Christ for our time.
Our fifth commitment. Catholics and Lutherans should witness together to the mercy of God in proclamation and service to the world. Please stand. Ecumenical engagement for the unity of the Church does not serve only the Church, but also the world, so that the world may believe. Let us now pray for the world, the Church, and all those in need.
God of mercy, throughout history your goodness prevails. Open the hearts of all people to find you and your mercy that endures forever.
Hear our prayer.
God of peace, bend that which is inflexible, the barriers that divide, the attachments that thwart reconciliation. Bring peace in this world, especially in the name of countries and places where there is much violence. Restore the wholeness among us and show us your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of justice, healer and redeemer, heal those who suffer from illness, poverty and exclusion. Hasten justice for those suffering under the power of evil. Give new life to all and show us your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of love, your Son Jesus reveals the mystery of love among us. Strengthen the unity that you alone sustain in our diversity. Your mercy endures forever.
Hear our prayer.
In confidence that God hears our prayers for the needs of this world and for the unity of all Christians in their witness, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
For all that God can do within us, for all that God can do without us.
Thanks be to God.
For all in whom Christ lived before us, for all in whom Christ lives beside us.
Thanks be to God. For all the Spirit wants to bring us, for where the Spirit wants to send us.
Thanks be to God.
The blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you on your way together, now and forever.
Amen.